So I love when I get these emails. Send your emails, ask me questions. I love making videos to answer the questions that you specifically want to ask. Because you know what? If you have this question, there's probably another 20, 30, or 40 other people that have the same question. They just haven't asked. So go ahead, send me emails, ask me questions, and then I will try to get around to answering them for you. Now here's one. It came from Pamela, and it said, "Hi Jerry, I just found you on YouTube. Have you trained as a florist before branching out into deco mesh wreaths?" Now, what she means by that is this is in regards to one of our Christmas videos where we have a lot of deco mesh. So, first of all, Pamela, no, I did not train. I'm not AIFP certified. I am self-taught. I started teaching myself how to make flowers, particularly dried flowers is what I started out with. About when I was 16 years old, and I'm 57, so you do the math, a long time. And basically, I've just studied floral designers over all those years. I've been actually doing it professionally now for about 30 years, and I've owned my own shop for 20 years now. So to go on and answer more of your questions, it says, being British, meaning her, she's quite conservative. How do you know when to stop embellishing the mantle garland without going over the top? I saw the wreath you made on another video, and now this garland, they are beautiful. I feel so inspired, but I'm afraid of getting it wrong. Any advice would be great. Thanks. Pamela, here's the deal. When you are making flower arrangements, it's a piece of art, okay? That's the beautiful thing about this and the toughest part about this industry. When you're making floral arrangements or anything to do with design, it's art. And what that means is you can't overdo it if you like it. There's only two people that you really need to be concerned with pleasing. That's you and your customer. So if your customer likes it, it doesn't matter whether you like it or not, right? But if you're just making something, then make it and make it until you're happy with it. I mean, this here is a wreath I just finished making. I have all different types of textures. I have grapevine wreath with the base. Then I came back in and I basically embellished it with wild honeysuckle. And then I took tree branches covered in lichen and mosses and put that on there. And that was my actual base. I got three different textures going on before I even started with the flowers. And then we bring in some permanent botanicals of foliages and then very few flowers here. Could I do more? Absolutely I could. Now, I'm going to stop here, but then again, there are other people that this may be too much for. You know what? I'm making this one. Hopefully, somebody will see it and love it and want to buy it. But this is my art, and this is the way I want to make it. This is my style, and that's how you develop your own style. So don't worry about over-embellishing. Do it until you think it strikes a chord with you. This is Jerry with DesignsByJerry.com and Sassy Flower Talk, answering your questions and helping you understand how to be a better floral designer, whether it's at home or it's in your own professional floral shop. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.